Some of the diseases you talk about that we might need injections for: cholera. You mentioned hepatitis A and B, influenza. Certainly, we're all thinking about annual flu shots right now. The new swine flu. They're saying seniors will be last on the list as opposed to first on the list, which is unusual. Health workers and young children, I guess, are going to be the first, and young adults. Early priority for the swine flu this year.
Yes. Those recommendations, they're still working on them right now, but that is what it looks like it's going to be. Looks like the hardest hit people right now, some of them are the younger people, mm-hmm. as compared to some of the older people.
Pregnant women especially, they're finding a lot of incidences of swine flu there.
Yes. I do want to mention that as far as cholera is concerned, we don't have that vaccine anymore in the United States. Mm-hmm. So that is something that is not available anymore.
All right. We mentioned influenza. Measles. I always felt if you had measles as a kid, you wouldn't get them again. Is that true?
It's true as far as if you had them, and most people in Laguna Woods here who are traveling and are born after 1956, which would be most all of them, you don't have to worry so much about getting the measles because they had them. Mm-hmm. But for somebody who was born after 1956, they were only giving one MMR. They never had the measles, and those individuals may have to get a second one.
Right. Okay. Things like malaria, pretty scary. Those of us who've been through the Panama Canal know all the horror stories about the mosquitoes and draining the swamps before they could actually build the canal. Is that still a risk in parts of the world?
Very much so. Very much so. But what is nice is that there are many different types of anti-malarial out now. They've had to make new ones because of, like, chloroquine used to be readily available, but now there's some chloroquine-resistant areas, so that doesn't work anymore. So they are getting newer anti-malarial medications that mm-hmm. are very effective.
You mentioned Rwanda, obviously an area that maybe a lot of people might not want to go to because some of the unrest there. Yes. But you also mentioned China, which is, yes, a communist country, but certainly welcomes tourism, albeit their visa form is rather extensive. But you're suggesting a few shots even for China.
Yes, even for China. Again, you're eating out a lot when you're on a trip, hepatitis A. Tetanus, even if you're not traveling, you should mm-hmm. have that. If you haven't
tetanus
had it
really
in the
should
last
be updated
years.
For everybody, I guess.
Correct. Every 10 years.
Yeah, okay.
And that's pretty much it for China, except
right.
if you're going to real rural areas.
Yeah.
But if you go to the major tourist areas, right. those are the main two.
Going to Hong Kong, Shanghai, Beijing, you're probably going to get away with a minimum on that.
Correct.
But again, you need to know all that complete information.
Yes.
Obviously, this is not a free service. What are we looking at cost-wise? I guess it depends on what you need as far as injections as part of it.
Correct. Now, the first time you come in, there's an office visit fee of $50, and that's only a one-time fee. So mm-hmm. you can come back five or six times and later on and never pay that fee again.
Yep.
So that's one-time fee. As far as the cost of the shots, they range anywhere from $35 to $135, mm-hmm. depending on what
How
you're getting.
How many you need, yeah.
Exactly.
And aren't some of these a series, like hepatitis? Don't you have to get those in a series?
Yes. For example, hepatitis A, you can get that one shot. That is actually good for a year.
Mm-hmm.
But if you get that second shot in 6 months to a year after the first one, it's good for a lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really worth, once you start that series, mm-hmm. it's worthwhile mm-hmm. to continue.
Okay. We're all concerned about our costs these days. Lots of discussion in Washington about health care right now. I understand Medicare does not cover travel immunization.
That is correct. Medicare does not cover travel immunizations, and neither would a supplement to a Medicare mm-hmm. Cover. But if you have a PPO, you're working, or if you have a PPO insurance, you should give them a call and see if they cover travel immunizations.
Mm-hmm.
And that's probably the word to use when you talk with them. Some do, some don't. There's so many different policies out there, you just have to call to find out. Now, as far as the HMOs, a lot of the HMOs are by Monarch here, and they have many different policies. Again, you need to call and find out if it's covered. If they do cover, then the policy we have with Monarch is that the client would pay up front as they're getting the immunizations, and then they would send that into their insurance to get reimbursed.
Right. Okay. Lots of things to think about. If you want to find out more, you can stop by and pick up the paperwork, but it's not a drop-in clinic, so we don't urge you to walk in there and roll up your sleeve because you're not going to get those injections that day.
Correct.
Thanks for joining us and filling us in, Karen. Some
okay.
important information. If you're planning a trip or wanting to travel or just want to stay healthy, some good information coming our way on the Travel Wellness Center over there at the clinic at the Saddleback Memorial Medical Center. We'll be back with more as our program continues for Tuesday.
The civic-minded citizens and physicians who planned Saddleback Hospital envisioned a full-service, high-tech hospital.
The medical center is a state-of-the-art facility that continually upgrades to remain state-of-the-art.
Our success is a highly skilled, diverse, and caring staff who meets all of your healthcare needs.
We represent virtually all medical specialties, and we practice in close proximity to you, our patients.
Saddleback Memorial Medical Center, keeping the village healthy since 1974.